Percentiles are position measures, and they often use the symbol P with a small number. So you could draw a line and mark each percentile as you see on the screen. Percentiles are different than percentages. For example, if a student gets 84 questions correct on a 100 question test, she obtained a percentage score of 84. This tells nothing of her position in the data set of students that took the test. However, if she scored in the 84th percentile, then she did better than 84% of the students that took the test. To find the percentile of a given value, the formula used is percentile equals number of given values below x, where x is a given number, plus 0.5 divided by the total number of values in the data set times 100. Here is a data set for subscribers gained for a 1 month period for 20 new YouTube channels. Let's say that we wanted to find the percentile rank for Jackie K's fashion channel, which is 18. The first thing we do is arrange the data in order of smallest to largest. Next, we substitute into the formula. So our x value is 18, and we need to find the number of values in the data set below 18, which is 12. Plug that in, add 0.5, and divide that by 20, the number of values in the data set, and multiply by 100. Doing the calculations, we get percentile equals 62.5. So we would say the value of 18, or Jackie K's channel, is higher than 62.5% of the other data values or channels in this data set. Now let's look at finding a data value corresponding to a given percentile. The formula for this is DV equals N times P divided by 100. In this formula, DV stands for data value, or the location in the data set. N equals the number of values in the data set, and P equals the given percentile. And there are two rules for this formula. If the formula results in a non-whole number, round up to the next whole number. For instance, if the formula produced 3.5, round up to 4. Or if the formula does result in a whole number, use the halfway value between the resulting whole number and the next whole number. For instance, if the formula produced the number 8, use the halfway value between 8 and 9. Let's do an example for each of these. So working with our previous data set, let's say we want to find the 80th percentile. We again first arrange the data in order of smallest to largest. Then substituting into the formula, we have DV equals 20 for N, the number of values in the data set, times 80 for P, the given percentile, divided by 100, and we get a result of 16. Since 16 is a whole number, we need to use the halfway value between the resulting whole number and the next whole number, so 16 and 17. We find the 16th value in the data set, which is 23, and the 17th value in the data set, which is 24. Next, we find the halfway value by adding 23 plus 24 and dividing by 2, which is 23.5. So 23.5 corresponds to the 80th percentile. Now let's say we wanted to find the 58th percentile. Using our equation, we have 20 times 58 divided by 100, which equals 11.6. So in this case, we round up to 12. So we find the 12th value in the data set, which is 17. So 17 corresponds to the 58th percentile. All right, my friends, hopefully this video helped you out. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time. I am out of here.